All right, this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com, standing next to my lychee tomato that actually just got me. Take a look at this plant, man. This is a lychee tomato, and you know, plants have protections against predators, and this lychee tomato has some crazy thorns coming on the leaves, and actually this is what stuck me down here. These are like little thorns on every leaf, on the bottoms, I mean on the tops, and the bottom of the leaf, man. Those are some crazy thorns. If you need some toothpicks, man, free toothpicks right here. And check out these beautiful flowers. This is in the tomato family, Solanaceae family. And I haven't tried eating those. And here's the fruit. Check out these fruit. These fruits are in these little pod things. And these pod things even have like little stickers on them. Here's the biggest one. And I suppose when they ripen up, maybe these things like kind of open up. And I have no idea what these taste like, because I've never tried them before. But these are lychee tomatoes, and the seeds originated from rareseeds.com, or the Petaluma Seed Bank. Today's show is not going to be about lychee tomatoes. What it's going to be about is, how long does it take to garden? Or, you know, how much time does it take, John? That's one of the biggest questions that I get many times. So in this episode, we're going to talk about how much time it takes to garden. How much time it takes depends on you and depends on how much you want to grow and if you want everything neat and tidy and orderly. Because if you don't, if you want things just grow, and you know, we'll go over to my tree collards over there and we'll show you what's how it's looking when we don't spend any time on it. You know, if you want to take time to pull weeds so everything looks nice and tidy, it's going to take you a lot more time. But if you don't care about the weeds and want to let them grow up and not do all the weeding and the leafing and things like that, you know, and maybe have a more, you know, artistic garden. Like I let my front bed go, you know, a couple episodes ago. You see, it just went crazy, and that took literally no time. The watering thing went off every day. It got watered, and it grew, and it did its thing, and I'd go out there only on the front bed just to harvest. Now, these other beds now, you know, every day I'll walk around and take a look and make sure everything is growing really well, and if things aren't, I'll adjust. So, I mean, every day you should maybe walk around and take a look at everything, just a glance. That doesn't take that long. But the main investment of the time it will take for you to garden is actually setting up your garden. And if you set it up right, it's actually going to save you time in the long run. So here's what I mean. So building the raised beds, so we have raised beds here. Now, raised beds, building those correctly, you know, do it right the first time, took some time. But now that they're built, you know, now it means less bending, you know, to plant the plants, and we put a drip irrigation system in, so that saves time every single day from watering. How many people do you know that have a garden and they don't have an irrigation system or drip irrigation that actually saves water and time? So you don't have to be out there with the hose every day and watering. So set up smart. The other way raised bed saves time is because we filled it up with 100% compost that basically was sterile for the most part. Sterile as in the seeds that were the weed seeds in there are heated up in the compost so hot that they are basically deactivated. The compost is still alive because it's teeming with bacteria, and that's the good stuff, but seeds and weed seeds are not in there. So if you're just growing in regular soil that you bring in, or your own soil, you know, and you grow in there, then weeds are going to start sprouting up. But when you're using compost from a, you know, a verified source that's been composted correctly, you shouldn't have any problems with weed seeds. So that means less weeding. So less weeding saves time with the drip irrigation, and you know, saves your back and you know, bending over. And so that's why I did the raised bed, so that could save time. But yes, building them does take some time, as you saw with our episodes with Rick and Karen, the 7 episodes that they had, all 10-minute episodes. So that's about 70 minutes of clips that took place across, you know, a couple weekends of time just to get the raised beds built. But you know what, that's a one-time investment, and that's the biggest thing I have to say. You know, you're gonna spend a big one-time investment. Once it's all built and get growing and you get going, you basically have some time invested to build the beds and then plant everything out, and then you put it on the watering system. Basically, it grows on its own. You don't have to really do anything. Maybe monitor it, make sure your plants look healthy, and if not, you need to make some adjustments. And depending on what you're growing, that could be easy or that could be really hard. So easy is things that grow really well in your climate and things that you know people in your area grow already. You know, tomatoes are usually one of the easiest things to grow. Lettuce can be harder because they're more affected by bugs and other things, and a little more temperamental. You know, if you want to grow things like stinging nettles or dandelions or lamb's quarters, you know, those are literally weeds, and they'll grow really easy without much care. You can only just take the seeds and throw them out and water them, and they'll come up, you know. I actually had a mallow coming up over my other bed that I just noticed, and I didn't plant it there, but I'm grateful that it's there, man. It looks really vibrant. And I love seeds when they just germinate on their own. So yeah, the main investment is the beginning. And then once you get it going, basically, and it's on the watering time, all you have to, the main investment is just coming out and harvesting what you want to eat. We all have a certain amount of time every day, and we need to dedicate that time to things that are important to us. And I really want to put it out there to my viewers and to people watching this video is that, you know, gardening and growing food should be one of the most important things to us. I mean, we all have to eat. I think we should all take responsibility for at least some of the food that we consume, because if we left it up to big farmers in agriculture, you know, and they went kaput one day, where would you be? So I think investing the time to learn how to grow your food and to eat, I mean, number one, you're gonna learn how to grow your food, you're gonna eat better, your family's gonna eat better, and you're gonna have this skill. And this is a skill, because not many people know this skill. In some foreign countries, everybody knows how to garden and farm, because if they didn't, they wouldn't be eating. But here in America, we have commercialized systems where we go to any grocery store and buy things for relatively inexpensive. But I think we should take a step back and all learn how to farm and grow our own food, because without that, without food, we wouldn't be alive. And most people don't have that, you know, capability to know how to grow their own food unless you start. So hopefully I've motivated you a little bit to get started growing, and hopefully you're already growing. Hopefully you're growing more because of me. And if you are, actually post down below, let me know what you're growing because of me. It really does make my day when I know that I'm able to help others on this planet to, you know, grow more of their food. And really, it doesn't really take that much time. It just depends on, you know, how much time you want to put into it. And it's actually a fun and learning experience. You get to be out in nature, smell fresh plants, and have nice scents. Here's some dill here growing, dill weed, smells nice. And it's just really, you have to spend some time somehow, and it all comes down to priorities, you know. If you're in a high paying job and you get paid a lot of money, right, but you want to grow your own food, well, you could set it all up or hire people to come in and set it up for you and hire people to take care of it for you. But sure enough, you could go out there and do a little bit of tending, you know, yourself. So that's the plan I take. I do a lot of my own gardening, but I have two part-time people that help me out here, you know, to make all this happen, because I have a, you know, high standard. I want to, and once again, I am growing food on a production level, so I'm growing food at home on a production level to actually feed a considerable amount of my diet. So here's an example of where gardening can take a lot of time. If you want it to look neat, orderly, and tidy, you're gonna have to do what I call leafing. So you can see these are my tree-collared trees here. They're 12 feet tall now, and every so often the leaves will just not make it. This one actually looks like it has a lot of white flies and aphid damage, and the lower ones just tend to pass away. So we just have to pick them off. So there's one, here's one that's not looking so healthy. Pick that one off, pick this one off. And here's more leaves that are not looking too good. So I mean, you just gotta keep up with this stuff, because every day there's more leaves that just aren't looking good. Now if I was really on it, I'd be eating these as fast as these are turning brown. And I'd pick all my lower leaves, eat all those, and let the ones in the center crowns continue to grow out. But I'm not that far on it. I've been harvesting more of my tree collards lately. Plus, looks like there is some aphid situation, so we need to spray with some probably high-pressure water to spray the aphids off, and maybe put some Dr. Bronner soap on there, too. So, yeah. So, leafing and weeding are probably the two biggest chores in your garden, because once you set it up, as I said, and you get it on a drip system, you pretty much just plant it and forget it. You just let the drip system go, let it water. I mean, sunlight comes out every day. As long as the soil has good nutrition, things are gonna grow. You just gotta basically come out and harvest, unless you see some insect damage, bugs, or disease, in which case then you'll have to maybe do a little bit of research, figure out what's going on, and find a good organic control to control whatever's going on. Or my solution in many cases is just I plant extra. I plant extra, some for the bugs and some for me, and I'm always able and left with some food. Gardening is fun. It's a fun, enjoyable activity that, you know, is good for us to be out in nature. And you know what? When you come home and when you start to garden, you'll just get engrossed in it. It's a fun thing to do. So you shouldn't really even think about, it's a pain. How much time is it going to take? You should think, hey, gardening is fun for me. It's fun for the planet. It's good for me. It's good for the planet. It's just good for anybody, and I think gardening is a great way to spend your time, especially when you're harvesting your own food. I mean, check this out. These are some radishes here. These are actually called watermelon radishes. We're going to go ahead and pull one up right here. And this is fun. I'm going to eat this tonight. And here's a little watermelon radish. These grow really fast. These are ready within 30 days. So it was just less than 30 days ago we planted these. We have little radishes to eat. But besides the radishes, you could eat the radish greens, and actually they're quite delicious. Radish greens, it's what's for dinner. We all have a certain amount of time every day to do with whatever we want, and I would encourage everybody to take, you know, some time to do some gardening. It's really great to be out in nature, to be, working with plants, to let them grow. And, you know, after all, it's the plants that nourish us here on the planet. You know, I think gardening for an hour is definitely a lot better than being a couch potato for an hour, but everybody needs to make their own choices in life. So this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing, and start growing if you haven't, at least in a container, because it really doesn't take that much time.